Hello, my name is Joan Nakitende. I'm also known as Joan Wamkisa, around church premises and church settings. I am a minister at Christian Discipleship Ministries International. So I'm a minister here and I minister in the media team. I'm also a personal assistant to one of the pastors. Yeah, that's basically what I do, and I enjoy serving the Lord. I was brought up in a Catholic family, and you know, as a Catholic, you get baptized when you're still in your diapers, and they introduce you to this God who created the heavens and the earth. So as you continue to attend Mass, you get introduced to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, and the things of that sort. So by the time I was about 5 years old, I was being introduced to the idea of going for, I've forgotten what it is, but yeah, it's called catechism, the primary course that you do as a Catholic person. We used to do them as children. So I was being introduced to catechism, and I wanted to know who this God is, and inside me I had that hunger to know and understand who he is. So one day I was asleep, and I saw a small light, and this small light started growing big and big, and before I knew it, I was facing an angel. The angel was looking at me, I was looking at him. He was so big, bigger than the room, but at the same time I would like his head was in the room, but he was bigger than the room. I don't know how to explain that, but that's what happened. So I asked him, no, he spoke first. He told me his name. He told me, my name is Gabriel. I said, what? You're Gabriel? He said, yes. So I asked him, are you the one who came to tell Mary? Because I knew Mary, I knew Jesus. Are you the one who came to tell Mary about her son? He said, yes. And you know, Jesus, he introduced Jesus to me and told me that if you give your life to Jesus, everything will be okay. So inside me, I didn't understand it. Then he asked me, do you understand what I've said? I told him, no. So he explained more and more of this Jesus. But as a child, I don't think I really understood it. All I knew is I needed to seek more of this Jesus. So that's where my journey began. I started during that same year, they opened LTV. So there was Benny Hinn, there was Joyce Meyer, there was Creflo Dollar, all those programs, plus the ones for children. So I used to watch them and slowly get introduced to this Jesus that had been introduced to me by the angel. So I kept searching. I went on, did my confirmation classes, but I felt like something was missing in my life. So in my P5, I discovered that actually the Holy Spirit is on this earth and is doing mighty things. But I didn't give it much thought. I was just fascinated by what this Holy Spirit was doing. The healings, the miracles, the people falling down when someone touches them, things like that. So it was until my P7 that I actually really gave my life to Christ. I was 12 years old. I started experiencing the Holy Spirit because I started speaking in tongues. I started seeing angels again, because the other time it only happened once, and I don't know if I saw them again, but what I remember is I started seeing angels again at the age of 12. So I started serving God because the Holy Spirit had come upon me. Now, I wanted to tell those of you who are watching me that many times we say that ndoko se, oh, I've given my life to Christ. But in actual sense, there are two things. There's the real conversion, and then there's a false conversion. There are many of us who give our lives to Christ. Naenga, we don't understand what we've done. We don't take it serious. So in the end, you find yourself, you are born again, but you continue in sin. You're born again, but you're still struggling with a habit. You're born again, but you feel ashamed to preach the gospel, you know? So I was that kind of person. Yes, I was serving God. I was feeling like I have the Holy Spirit. I went on to my secondary school, singing in the church choir, telling others about Jesus, trying to represent God because I thought that was what was right. Hallelujah. But in actual sense, I think something was missing. I had not understood the God I had believed. So I went on in this journey of salvation. I was persecuted for my faith, coming from a Catholic family. I was always beaten up for going to church. At some point, I was being asked not to stay in the house. Either someone stays in the house or me, you know. It was a hard time in my teenage age. So I go to A level and I tell this God, you know what, God, I have suffered enough for you. I have suffered enough, now I want to put this relationship on a break. Nkwagalanyo, I am serving you. I'm going to believe you in my heart, but I will not join the what? The SU. I will not join the Christian Union. I will not join those things. I'm just going to be on that, I'm going to keep my faith on the down low. So guess what? In my A level, my life was the opposite. Coming from a person who was serving God, preaching the gospel, telling others to pray, in A level things turned around. I was the one telling people, let's go and dance, let's go for Kadan, okay, let's go and do this. In fact, they changed my name from Joan to DJ Nachi. I'm sure I have an OJ who is watching out there. So they called me a DJ. I was the one, you know, promoting them to do things that are contrary to what a Christian would be doing. But inside me, I had my faith, but I had put it on hold. Now, this is what I was talking about, the false conversion. You might think you're converted, but there's something missing. If you're saying that you're born again, but deep inside you, something is missing. The Bible says that when we give our lives to Christ, we become a new creature, a new creature. The old is gone and the new has come. So meaning our lives have to be totally transformed. The way we talk, the way we speak, the way we do our things has to change. So it was until I was about to do my UNEB exams. So I get this God of mine from the closet where I had hidden him. I tell him, you know what, now we need to do final exams and I need to prove that I am actually a brilliant student. So I pull him out, I pray to him. Why am I speaking like this? It's because some of us, this is the way we treat God. Eh? We only go to him when we need something. We only go to him to use him. Like, let me give an example of women who date guys. I'm not talking about you Christian women, there are other women out there. You know, you date a guy and what you want from him is money for rent, money for your data, you want money for dressing up, you want money, you know. You just go to them to get those things. So sometimes, tukula katonda. We only go to him to get what we want, and then when we get that thing, we walk away. I have a message for parents out there. If your child chooses to seek God, if you're not born again, do not hinder them, because out of them God is building a person who is going to benefit the generation. Personally, right now, I am ministering also with the youth ministry, and I lead a certain prayer altar focused on destinies of the youth. So if I had not overcome all those challenges in my youth, I wouldn't have been able to understand what we youth, or what youth go through, coming from homes of people who are not born again, facing the different challenges. Eh? So I'm finishing university and my mother gets sick. My grandmother calls me and she tells me, you know what? I know your mom hasn't called you, but you should come and visit her. Now, we were in a time of doing exams, and I didn't know what to do because I had to be at school. That's why I was not so much in touch with her. But I sacrificed a weekend, and my university was far from our home. So I sacrificed a weekend and went back home. Oh my goodness, I was shocked to see what my mom looked like. I thought she was about to die the next second. But I'm bringing this example to remind you that when you're standing for Christ, do not give up, do not waver. So in this situation that my mom was in, she knew that she needed God. She was the one who used to cane me She was the one who used to ground me and tell me, you're not going anywhere this week because I don't want you to go to those born-again churches of Biwempe. She would be the one to tell me to switch off the TV, to tell people at home, don't allow that girl to watch TV because she's overwatching those Christian TVs. I don't understand what those American pastors are telling her. But here she is. One time she told me, something happened, and she told me, you know what, Joan, you need to get me a pastor. I said, what am I dreaming? I pinched myself. I said, should I become a daughter? So I looked around, tried to call people, and I realized it was real. It was happening. My mom was telling me, Joan, get me a pastor. I said, wow, this is amazing. So, see, if I had not stood, if I had wavered from this faith and said, I'm going to continue living a life of the, in church we call it the life of the world. If I had continued in that way, my mom would not have come to me. So she asked me to get a pastor. To cut the long story short, she gives her life to Christ. And from that time, she only lived for only 4 months after that. But I want to tell you that she preached the gospel to her Muslim siblings. She started a prayer altar at home. She was praying in tongues. She would go to church and she wouldn't miss a day. For as long as she was able to walk, she would go to church. As long as she had money, she would go to church. She would read the Bible, the Luganda Bible, the English Bible. You know, she started worshiping God. She did so many things for God in those few 4 months. And I believe if I hadn't stood, she wouldn't have come to Christ that fast. So after that, she passes on and then we have to survive. Actually, she passed on the last day of my exams of university. When I was doing the last paper, when I was going for the last paper, that's when she died. She died at about 6:30 a.m. My dad called me at 7 a.m. My paper was at 9 a.m. So I don't know if anyone understands this situation. I don't know how I did that exam, but the good news is I came out with a B+. It was a procurement course.